In this snapshot, we will discuss the new chemical quantity of concentration. We will also describe how you can use the process of dilution to go from a higher concentration to a lower concentration using some simple predictions. We will also introduce some new units and use dimension analysis to assist choosing the right algebraic process to convert between them. In chemistry, we work a lot with solutions, and we don't mean solving problems. We mean a mixture of chemical species dissolved into another phase. We saw solutions in the intermolecular forces lab. When two liquids were mixed, we determined they were soluble in each other. This is a solution formed by mutual solubility of the two liquids. However, it is far more common in the chemistry we will observe to see a solution formed from a liquid and a solid, where the liquid is most commonly water. In this example, we have a sodium chloride solution formed from solid sodium chloride crystals, which is our solute. We dissolve this up in our solvent, which is liquid water. Together, this forms a solution containing sodium cations, chloride anions, and water molecules. In a solution, we define solute, solvent, and solution to describe the different species present at each stage of the process to form a solution. A great contrast between two different solutions of sodium chloride in water. To cook your pasta for dinner, you dissolve salt into the pasta water, typically about a teaspoon or around 4 grams per litre. This gives flavour to your otherwise bland pasta. By comparison, the sea has around 40 grams of sodium chloride per litre. It's a lot more salty in taste because it has more sodium chloride for the same volume of solution. Seawater is more concentrated than water to cook pasta. Imagine the flavour of your pasta if you cooked it in seawater. Ugh, yuck. The new chemical quantity of concentration is defined as the amount of solute per amount of solution. The amount of either can be as mass, volume, or moles, depending on what we want to do with this quantity. Because there are many different ways of representing concentration as a chemical quantity, you need to be attuned to the units of concentration. The unit of concentration will give you a clue about what's the best approach to solve the problem containing this quantity. The types of units you may encounter are shown here, including where you might experience concentration. You may find mass per volume, moles per volume, or volume per volume units. Sometimes you may also find solid solutions, especially if you're in geology, and these are given as mass per mass units. However, we're going to focus solely on aqueous solutions, so let's look at some examples. For example, pasta water and seawater. The concentration of 4 and 40 grams per litre are given in the word descriptions of these solutions. So with this in mind, we can see how the formula for concentration gives rise to the units. If we have 4 grams in 1 litre, then we would have 4 grams per litre. And similarly for 40 grams per litre. This dimension analysis allows us to determine that we're working with mass per volume units of concentration. The seawater has a higher concentration of sodium chloride than pasta water, so this makes sense. However, we cannot apply the same logic when looking at two solutions with different solutes. It's like comparing apples and oranges. For example, sodium chloride and sodium iodide. When we weigh out the same mass of these chemical species, we have a different quantity of ions for the same mass, because 1 mole of sodium iodide weighs more than 1 mole of sodium chloride. So we need to use the equivalent form of molar concentration, of moles per litre. This ensures that we can compare apples with oranges. First, we need to convert the mass to the number of moles using its molar mass. Note that sodium chloride is 58.44 grams per mole, while sodium iodide is 149.9 grams per mole. Also, pay attention to the dimension analysis, which gives us our desired units of moles. When we calculate the molar concentration, we have the number of moles per litre of solution. For these two solutions, they have the mass concentration of 5 grams per 500 mils, but very different molar concentrations. Because the molar mass of sodium chloride is about one-third that of sodium iodide, it is 3 times more concentrated. Again, note the dimension analysis, highlighting that we get the desired units of moles per litre. Don't forget to apply logic 2, like the threefold relationship between the molar masses giving a threefold difference between the concentrations. This sort of proportional reasoning will save you from silly arithmetic errors. We can also manipulate concentration through the process of dilution. Because seawater is more concentrated than the water we cook our pasta in, we could conceivably use seawater to cook our pasta. To achieve the correct concentration, we need to know a little about the quantities and concentrations, both of the solution we have and the solution that we want. In the lab, the process of dilution requires accurately known volumes, which is most frequently achieved with pipettes and volumetric flasks. To dilute the seawater, we draw up a known volume into the pipette. We dispense this into a volumetric flask that is our desired volume, and then make this up with deionized water. The deionized water is pure and does not contain sodium chloride. Therefore, the only sodium chloride added to the flask comes from the volume of seawater. This gives us a solution with a known concentration. Let's elaborate further. Let's say we want 2 litres of salty water to cook our pasta, and we know that this is best at 4 grams per litre. We have lots of seawater at 40 grams per litre, but what volume is required? As all matter is conserved, the known concentration times the unknown volume of seawater must equal the desired concentration of pasta water times the volume required to cook our pasta. By rearranging our equation for our unknown quantity, we find that our units of concentration cancel out, and we're left with units of volume of litres. We need 0.2 litres, or 200 millilitres, diluted to 2 litres to give our desired concentration of sodium chloride of 4 grams per litre. On reflection, we can see the difference in concentration is tenfold, and therefore we would need to dilute the seawater by tenfold to get the desired concentration. So, 0.2 litres in 2 litres makes logical sense. I can't emphasise how important this common sense check is when doing chemical calculations. In the upcoming workshop, we will explore concentration and dilution in more detail and provide plenty of examples for you to try. Thanks very much for your attention.